Hey everybody, welcome back to Devil Talk. Owen Yanker from the Davis Enterprise here as always with my co-host, fellow Blue Devil coach, head coach of the Davis High Swim Team, John Barley.
How's it going, guys? Thanks for joining us.
Yep, we're here with an awesome guest today, former NCAA All-American, Emma Barksdale. Emma, how are you?
I'm good. How are you guys?
Doing great.
Thanks for coming. Thanks for doing it. Yeah, so Emma, cool thing we're doing, just chatting with former swimmers from Davis High, seeing what they're up to. But we just thought we'd start off by asking you what you remember about swimming for Davis High, just any memories that stand out, and then when you did go to school at Davis High.
So I loved my time at DHS, like especially during swim season, just because I was always around like all my dart teammates and then some of the my teammates who lived in Vacaville in Sacramento. But I loved getting to know all the kids who like did swimming just for high school, and like they weren't really people that like I interacted with because we had like different schedules or just like weren't taking the same classes. So it was nice to meet new people, and I loved like getting to know them and like seeing them on campus and like being like, oh my gosh, like I do have a class with you, but like we never talked because I just didn't know you. So it was so fun to like meet new people that like I went to high school with. So
yeah, it's such a huge team too, right? So I mean, and there's people all over campus, you know, repping the Blue Devil shirts that you see walking by, and you're like, hey, like I saw you at the meet the other day, like good luck with your races this coming week. It really brings that camaraderie together, right? What years did you swim for the team?
So I graduated in 2015. Oh my God, I can't even do basic math. My freshman year would have been 2012, I think.
2012, like, yeah.
Yeah.
I graduated in 2011, so missed you by a year. Yeah.
Yeah.
So you swam with Owen then?
Yep. Yes. Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, were there any events, big meets, things that really stand out in your mind from your high school, you know, experience that you've kind of just like taken with you and kind of inspired you as you kept swimming, things like that?
Yeah, I always liked swimming at the St. Francis in Jesuit meet because I feel like that was one of the meets that like we actually went to, like our high school. Tracy was super kind to let us kind of like not like skip out, but like we were selective about some of the dual meets that we went to. But I really liked the Jesuit meet just because there wasn't like a warm down pool. And I know that kind of sounds weird, but one thing that I've like taken with me, like that I learned at that meet, is like you're not always gonna have like that ability and like to kind of like practice your routine when like you're not going to have enough warm down space or not enough warm up space, or there's too many people or your suit rips or anything like that. So like being able to be like, okay, like after my race, I'm not going to be able to warm down, but they're going to have like 10 minutes where like everyone's going to get in the pool. So like really using your time wisely. Yeah. I think that's like the biggest thing that stands out for me when I think about was always so like, oh my gosh, like there's not gonna be a warm down pool, but like you gotta work with it, like everyone there is not gonna be able to warm down. So
yeah, that pool definitely, you know, prepares you for the tough times at swim meets, and it is a mental game, right? So
yeah,
just planning ahead, knowing, okay, I'm not gonna warm down, not gonna be able to warm down, so what can I do instead, right?
Mm-hmm.
And knowing that everyone's in the same, you know, everyone's in the same boat. I remember having leagues there lots of years, right? League champs. And
yeah, you
know, take those breaks.
I remember my senior year, I don't know if the pools changed, but I remember going to leagues and I swam like one race, and I remember like getting ready in the car to go to prom like that same day.
Yeah. Prom's always conflicting with championships, right?
Yeah, so Emma, after high school, tell us what you did, where you went to school, and what that was like.
So I committed to swim for the University of South Carolina, which was in the SEC, which was a big goal of mine. I wanted to swim in the SEC just because it's so competitive. It has a really good legacy of developing swimmers. So I went there and I absolutely fell in love with the team. I love my coaches and all the girls and guys on the team. And living in the South was a big change for me from growing up in Davis, especially the weather. The humidity really got to me in the beginning. But I loved, I switched my majors freshman year and I got a degree in public relations, and I really enjoyed my time at the journalism school, which I think was the biggest thing for me, because I knew I wasn't prepared, or I wasn't thinking about swimming after college. I just knew that my degree that I got in college would be a really big factor as to what my life would be like. And so I actually never heard of public relations before I got there my freshman year. So I'm really thankful that I had all the support from the academic staff or the athletic department that helped me. So,
yeah. Cool. Very cool. So you've obviously had a very successful career in swimming, you know, you all over the team records for Davis High, you know, you're swimming in college as well. When did you find your stroke or your groove? I know like a lot of coaches are like, don't want to label it, right? But what would you consider to be your best event?
I would say the 400 IM, although I definitely sometimes don't like swimming it and I don't like practicing for it. But I don't think I really found like my signature events until maybe like my sophomore or junior year. Until then, I kind of just swam whatever events. Like, I didn't really have one that I was like, oh, like that's my event, like that's what I'm going to train for, which I am actually super thankful for, that Billy allowed me to do that in club swimming. So I really didn't like box myself in to swimming events, which I think kind of helped me become an IMer like as I got older. So I didn't really swim the 400 IM until maybe like, I didn't seriously start swimming it until like the end of my junior year, the beginning of my senior year. So.
Yeah. It's funny that you said earlier that you weren't really thinking too much about, you know, swimming after school being done. And then you and I have obviously talked about the ISL step, but what's that experience been like just being able to be a pro swimmer? Probably, I think, the first pro swimmer in Davis High history. But just what was that experience like this past year being a part of a professional swimming organization?
It was definitely surreal, because I knew after my senior year, I was like, okay, I'll keep swimming until Olympic trials, just to see, like, it was only going to be a few months. So I was like, I'll keep swimming. We had a few post-grads on the team already, so I kind of knew what like their schedule was going to be like and like what I could expect being a post-grad. But when I got the DM from Caitlin to do ISL, I was like, oh my gosh, like there wasn't a doubt on my mind that I wasn't going to do it. Like I wanted to do it because it was so new and it was a way for me to like meet people that like I wouldn't necessarily like interact with at swim meets and learn from them as to what it takes to be like that elite Olympic level swimmer. So when I got the DM from her, I was like, oh my gosh, like this is a sign that like I made the right choice, because I was kind of nervous that I was like, maybe like I shouldn't have, like I don't know if like swimming an extra year would be right for me. But when I got the DM from her, I was like, oh my gosh, like it was meant to be. So it was like a sign that I should keep swimming. And then yeah, so I have to keep swimming some more, but it's all good.
Yeah, so I mean, we all know that Olympics have been postponed another year, hopefully no longer than that. So can you tell us a little bit about what your training regimen is like now, what you're going to be preparing for, you know, in the coming years, and what you're doing right now?
So right now I'm just swimming with Dart in the mornings. So we have an hour and a half pool space, like practice time. So that's been super nice to be able to actually practice, because during quarantine, I have been swimming at my neighbor's pool. They have like a 16-yard lap pool. So I was actually able to like swim some laps and like kick and stuff like that, which was super nice. Before I was able to go to the gym, but they closed the gyms, which was kind of a bummer. So I've been working out in my garage, which is the only kind of like big difference, but, I'm waiting to hear back from the University of South Carolina, because they're kind of like in the process of ironing out some details about when they're going to open up the university pool, which is where the team trains and where I had been training the past 5 years. So I guess I'm kind of, whenever they open, I'll see like if the time is right to go back and be able to hopefully practice a little bit more, since the team has a bit more say about practice times than here in Davis. But for now, I've just been swimming with Billy in the mornings, which have been super nice, because I have the rest of the day to kind of do other things, like work out, do some schoolwork. But other than that, not much.
I'm literally curious myself, though. What was it like just traveling like you did with the ISL and going to those meets and swimming with, you know, having people on the team that, you know, people put on posters in their bedrooms?
Yeah, it was crazy. It was that, like, the first meet, I was so nervous, and like my roommate was Australian, and we had a few guys and girls from Australia, so I would like hang out with them, and I was like, oh my gosh, like, I'm so nervous to swim, like, these people are so fast. And it really didn't, like, I kind of like got in my groove. The 400 IM was like the second event, and so I was swimming it with Katie Ledecky, and we were like, oh, like, what are we gonna do when we walk out? Because they were like, do something fun. So we're like, oh, like, we'll hold hands and wave. And I was like, oh my gosh, I'm so sorry, like, my hands were kind of sweaty because I was so nervous. I was like, I'm like kind of nervous. And she's like, I'm nervous too. I was like, why are you nervous? What do you mean? Like, I get to be like, but I didn't like register with me that like this was new for everyone. So I think I was like, oh, okay, like, if she's nervous, like, I can be nervous and it's okay. Yeah, and so I loved it, and I'm super excited to see what they have. It'll be definitely different with COVID, but I'm excited to see what this next season is going to be like.
Having been through it all, I mean, swimming at the, you know, youth summer dart rec level, you know, going through club swimming, high school swimming, collegiate swimming, pro swimming, what advice do you have for, you know, younger swimmers now, high school kids or future high school athletes that are, you know, coming into the sport?
I feel like for me, if I could give myself advice, because I know in high school how hard it is to, like, balance, like, swimming is a very physically and mentally demanding sport where you're up super early and you don't really have like a social life like after school, and then on the weekends you have meets. So for me, I think the biggest piece of advice I would give is like if you're kind of in a rut, like, really lean on your teammates, because those are the people that are like going through the same experiences as you, and really embrace like being a part of a team, because they're the people that understand what you're feeling the most. And just to talk through, like, it's okay, like, I don't know how many times I felt like I wanted to be done with swimming, because I was like, I don't want to wake up early anymore, like, I want to be normal. But now, like, I'm like, oh, I do not know what I would do with a normal life. So just to like be able to lean on those closest around you and lean on your teammates, because they always know what you're going through. They always understand. So that's what I would say.
Yeah, lean on your teammates. They're always there for you. Be there for them. Be a good teammate. All right. Well, thank you, Emma. Thanks for coming on today.
Great advice. My Wi-Fi was so spotty. I don't know why it was like that.
Totally fine. We really appreciate the time, and good luck to you in the future and with your training coming up. And we'll all be watching you in the trials.
Hopefully, it happens.